Hey y'all, it's time to get lit. Hey,
BCB,
yeah,
Bounce Cheap.
Yeah, y'all already know we came here to have a good time. You feel me?
Hey, it's time to turn up.
Yeah, turn up with the real Boss Squad. Yeah, you already know.
I mean, you did come here to have a good time, right? What's happening, brothers and sisters? You are listening to The Tour on the Sister Speak Show. That's right, this is a fresh episode of The Tour where we are covering all aspects of the music industry. I am your host, Sister Speak, recording from the D, brothers and sisters. That's right. I missed y'all. I'm okay, and I know you're okay, so let's get into it. Tonight's episode on The Tour: Deadly and Dangerous, When Chaos and Calamity Strikes Concerts and Clubs. Whew, the Sister Speak Show is where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action, a talk show for great minds that create, inspire, impact, and evolve. Sister, spiritual inspiration shared through the arts. Sister, spiritual inspiration shared through Ayana, but you better call me Sister Speak. What's popping, y'all? How y'all doing? Shout out to everybody who downloads, who listens internationally, nationally, locally. I really appreciate your downloads. Shout out to Cambodia, okay, Tanzania, Zimbabwe, Ethiopia, Kenya. Who else did I see? Laos. I saw you all. Barbados. Oh my goodness, there are so many of you all listening. Please don't be mad if I didn't shout you out. I got you next time, but I just want you to know I see you all listening, and it is a joy divine that you all, out of all the podcasts that you listen to and probably do listen to, that you are adding us to your playlist, your podcast shuffle. We thank you for allowing us to be the flavor in your ear. And for those of you, let me code switch, the flavor in your ear. I really appreciate you in totality. Okay, let's get into this. My background music right now is Get Lit. This is Boss Chica, straight out of the D. The D, what you talking about? Dallas. That's right. Okay, brothers and sisters. And it is time to get lit in the right way. To my first time listeners, I want to welcome you to the Sister Speak Show Network. I just want to warn you in advance that the Sister Speak Show Network is rated R for strong language, thoughts, ideas. Warning you in advance, I'm not going to warn you again. I'm not going to make any excuses for anything that I say. We keep it 1 million on the Sister Speak Show Network, period. I want you to know that you're going to need two things whenever you listen to any episode of the Sister Speak Show. You're going to need water. You're going to need scuba gear. You need water because it's your healing power. It's your gas, reflective power. It's everything that you need. If you don't like water, you cannot listen to this show. Mm-mm. If you're one of those people that say, I think water is nasty, I can smell you right now. We don't even do that. That means you are definitely anti-village. Seriously, because it is imperative that you like water. Your body is made up of 95% of water. How could you not like water? That is detrimental to all aspects of your life. You're not winning if you don't like water. I'm telling you that right now. If you're the type of person like, well, I just got to add something to it, I just can't drink it plain. Demonic. And we definitely return to sender. You are the type of person that wants the roof to stay on fire. You want it to burn. Mm-hmm. You are the one that says, we don't need no water. Let the motherfucker burn. Burn, motherfucker, burn. That's you. You are the burn, motherfucker, burn type. I cannot have you around me, you pyromaniac. Listen, every time you talk, you go boof. Just catch up in flames. You are dehydrated if you don't like water. And no wonder the spiritual attacks are whooping your behind. No wonder you are not winning at all. You are on the losing end of the battle. And that's just not how you were set up to be if you've been chosen. If you are part of the 12 tribes of Israel, by the way, just want you to know, I'm for all shades of brown people, all 12 tribes of Israel. Make no mistake about it. I don't straddle the fence about it. I am pro village. I am pro Yah, pro Most High God. I am pro upliftment, encouragement, uprightness. I'm all for it. I am pro standing in your power. I am pro warrior, all of that, pro self-defense, all of that. You need to know that about the Sister Speak Show right now. This is not your average podcast. I'm not your average podcast host. This is what I love to do. So just get ready. Keep up. I'm not going to slow down when I talk. You need to just listen. Get on. That's why I said you need that water so your ears can keep up, because we're about to really keep it going. Oh, we've got a nice show for you all this evening. The content is always great. Okay, I'm a news personality, according to Instagram. That's just what it is. No, seriously, this is what I do, brothers and sisters. So I'm so glad to kind of switch it up and get out of the whole vent session vibe just for a little bit and just get into this music industry news, okay? That's what it's about. So guess what? I got a treat for you. For us? You do? Yes. I have a treat. What is it? Like, what is it? I'm going to tell you right now. I've got a song for you. Mm-hmm. See, I know some amazing people, right? That's what I love about what I do. I have met celebrities, local, national, I just met celebrities. I have met dope people who do dope things. And so the connections that I still have, I cherish, and we are bonding. Like, we are solid. And so I am cool with an artist, a musician, a boss, a CEO, a really good guy from Philly. Shout out to Philly, y'all. Hey, Philly. Philly in the house. His name is Mont Music, and he has artists. I'm going to be interviewing one of his artists on the 27th by the name of Marski. I want you all to get ready. Shout out to Marski in advance. It's going to be an epic interview. I know y'all like, ooh, Sister Speak, you ain't had an interview on the podcast in a minute. But I have had interviews on IG Live. That's why you need to follow me at I Am Sister Speak. Okay? Hit the like, share, subscribe, all of that. Tap all the way in. So you'll know what's all the way going on. So anyway, Mont Music has an artist by the name of Lydia, and they have a new song. Well, they have a song called One Time, y'all. And I'm just so grateful that I have the privilege to be able to play that for you all right now. Mm-hmm. International debut, okay? So to all of my listening countries, continents, cities, states, I just want you to know that you're about to be blessed with what you hear. And I want you to stream it, support, you know, go follow, and just really just tap into what we're about to do. So before we even get into tonight's content, we're going to drop this. No, we're not going to drop it, because if we drop it, it'll break. We don't want to break this. This is something you have to treat right. We're going to actually go ahead and put this up, because anything going down is crashing. So brothers and sisters, I want you to tap all the way in and listen to this song right here. Lydia featuring Mont Music, One Time. Let's get it. Let's go. Shout out to you, Mont.
Like a queen, swear I'll be good to you. Just say you'll be my boo. is amazing. This is so crazy. Damn, little baby. Good night, I want you. I can't deny. All I really wanna do is get you to the crib and show you how a nigga really do. All I really wanna do is get you to myself and show you how a nigga really do. Little baby, tell me what it is that you wanna do. When you ain't gotta ask, we can go and do it. I'm trying to kick you with you, but you think I'm playing. All I really wanna do is show you that I'm committed. See, baby girl, I'm just trying to show you what you have in front of you. And ain't nobody gonna do your body like the way I do. I do. Do your body like I do.
Oh, baby, I just need one time. Get with me, I'm just trying to vibe. No games, I'ma show you how I do it.
That was One Time by Lydia featuring Mont Music. Mont, you better quit playing with me. We'll be right back after these commercial breaks. That's a 10.
When it comes to being a rap lyricist, what sets you apart is your ability to be able to freestyle on demand. If you can't freestyle, you can't rap. The latest episode of the Tour on the Sister Speak show is available on demand now. In this episode, beatdowns versus bars, when freestyle battles turn violent. Rated R for strong content and language. On the tour, we cover all aspects of the music industry, focusing on musicians, managers, songwriters, producers, music groups, DJs, with exclusive music, as well as concert reviews and IG Live concerts and interviews. On the Sister Speak show, where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action. A talk show for great minds that create, inspire, impact, and evolve. Go ahead and click the link for the latest episode. Brotherhood, sisterhood, leadership. Those are the qualities that you were looking for when you were joining, not humiliation. The latest episode of The Culture Climate on the Sister Speak show is available on demand now. Rated R for strong content, language, and thoughts on this episode. Death Before Degree, Hazing in Fraternities and Sororities. On The Culture Climate, we're covering what others are afraid to cover in the village, including controversial conversations, taboo subject matters, addressing the inner me's, exposing the enemies, interviews, audio from video clips, international, national, local news affecting the village. Click the link for the latest episode on the Sister Speak show, where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action. A talk show for great minds that create, inspire, impact, and evolve. Remember, you don't have to die to belong.
Murder, mystery, intrigue, suspense, all of the elements that make up The Suspense Files on the Sister Speak show, and the latest episode is available on demand now. On this episode, Expelled, No One Will Tell, Murder in the Student Body. On the Suspense Files, we are covering the who, what, when, where, why in urban crime, from deadly relationships to urban cold cases and more. For all shades of brown people, this episode is rated R for strong language, thoughts, and ideas. It's time to click the link and podcast and chill with the Sister Speak show, where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action. A talk show for great minds that create, inspire, impact, and evolve. If no one tells, someone may get away with murder. Are you going to let that happen? We'll see.
You already know what time it is. I appreciate you choosing to podcast and chill with the Sister Speak Show on tonight's episode of the tour. I mean, you know, if you want to wipe me down, you can. Well, I don't want you to walk me down, but you could definitely wipe me down. Brothers and sisters, tonight's episode on the tour, Deadly and Dangerous. When chaos and calamity strikes concerts and clubs, ooh-wee. We about to get into it, brothers and sisters. I know you've been to a concert, and I know you've been to a club. Most of you have, right? You already know what the environment is. You already know that the temperature is going to be high, and the element of surprise isn't really the element of surprise anymore. You know the playout can automatically be that the shit can go left when it should just be going right. You pay your money, you're getting ready to go out, you get the function is getting ready to allegedly pop, and you about to be in that thing, you, your crew, solo or not. And here you are in the midst of all kind of chaos and calamity because disaster has completely taken over the event. No matter if you pay $5 to get in or if you're paying $150 to get in, chaos and calamity can strike a concert and a club. We know that because we see that just with the recent events and just with events that have happened in the past. If you're up on the news, if you read, if you actually engage in what's going on, okay? You can't just sit around and not know what's going on in the world, in this particular world, because you'll end up in a guillotine. So with clubs and concerts, it's almost at enter at your own risk. I don't care if ladies get in free before 10. I don't care if the drinks are free before 10. Whatever the situation is, whatever the baits are, whenever you go through those doors or whenever you go through whatever the entranceway is, it is literally enter at your own risk in this day and time. Because there are always energies that choose to engage in the fuckery, the foolery, the satanic and demonic activities and energies that will cap off the entire event. You didn't pay all your money for this shit. You didn't pay money to run. If that's the case, you would have gone to the gym. Here you are exercising your gym membership at a club or a concert. You don't know which way to go. You know, everything is chaotic. And that's how people end up on the floor. And that's how there are deaths that occur as a result of the energy. Now, there are some people. Now, you are listening to the tour now. We're covering all aspects of the industry, music industry. There are some people who want to pretend like Beelzebub doesn't exist, okay? There are people who want to pretend like this isn't really happening and that it's something totally different. They want to live a lie. But I'm just here to tell you that this shit is really wicked out here. And the devil does not, Beelzebub gives no fucks about anybody. But he will use people in order to do his dirty work. And in these clubs and in these concerts, there are energies looking for it to be completely a night of terror, a day of terror. What is it about these events or these artists that attract, allegedly, these type of energies that create the chaos and the calamity? Now, because some of you all idolize artists, okay, musicians, you're willing to defend their fuckery. You're willing to defend the fact that even though you see them giving the devil a lap dance, that's not really what the case is. You are completely brainwashed into believing that everything that you see is not really happening, but it is. And you're the reason why they're able to keep going, because your energy keeps them going. If it weren't for your energy, they wouldn't be able to manifest in the way that they do. They wouldn't be able to reach the levels that they reach. You don't reach certain levels without entertaining certain devils. That's just how spirituality, this thing goes when you tap into that dark side. It's just a fact. Nobody can get mad at that. These are the realities of life. You know what you're doing when you enter, when you show, rather, you know, symbols, and you show signs, and you do gestures, and you hang out with certain people that sleep upside down, that slither, that creep in the night, that engage in things that are not okay, okay? But because you idolize these people, you are willing to go to bat even in ignorance for these people. Blindness, you're deaf because you are consumed by the frequency and the vibrations and they're low. You are being reeled in. And so you may end up going to an event, or you probably will end up going to an event that is not for your greater good, but you don't care because you idolize this person. In your eyes, they can do no wrong. You literally feel like this person is your hero, and you will find reasons to justify why this person is worth you entering into doom to hear them perform, to see them perform. In this world, you have, in totality, you can only serve one master, not two. Who do you serve? And now let's just ask the question, who does the musician or musicians that you idolize, who do they serve? And when they thank God, who are they thanking? Because they're not thanking the Most High God and Yah. So what God are they thanking? That's just the intelligence of the situation, the wisdom of it. These clubs and concerts are designed for energy to be sucked from you. Now, let's just get into it. Have you ever gone to a club? Yes. Have you ever gone to a concert? Most of you, yes. Have you ever been to a club where shit popped off? I have, several times. Have you ever been to an event where shit popped off? You have, several times, okay? Have you ever had to run? Have you ever had to duck? Have you ever been to a club where they started shooting, started fighting? Have you ever been to an event where you were dancing, just minding your own business? You know what I'm saying? You in that thing so fresh and so clean. Can't nobody tell you nothing, Nathaniel. And you are in that thing, okay? And you are, look, the DJ is playing all your songs. This is it. You got your dance moves together. Like, you really in there. Like, you feel like you are the champion of the club that night. And the DJ, for some fucked off reason, wants to start asking people where they're from. And so they want everybody to call out their sets. Everything was fine, DJ, until you started calling attendance. The moment you started trying to check in with people and have people tap in by telling where they're from, shit went left. It's we're talking about the micro chaos, the macro chaos, the micro calamity, and the macro calamities that occur in concerts and events, because this is leading all the way up to what just was, you know, before our eyes in Houston. But I do my own thing. I do my own spin, my own twist on what I want to do. So this is how it's going to go. Okay, I'm just not going to outright start talking about it. I am a teacher in nature, by nature. So it is only right that the Sister Speak Show would have a curriculum, you know, even while we're having a good time and talking about this. So here it is. The DJ is sitting up here. Everything is fine, DJ. You were doing well. Hold on. Let me fill up. Y'all, let's take a break and fill up. I say joy instead of cheers. So joy to everybody. But I got to get this petrol. That was good. So the DJ is calling out. You know, he's on the ones and twos. She's on the ones and twos. Normally, it's a he. And so everybody's in there. It's kind of thick. You know what I'm saying? You can't really tell who's all in the building, but you know it's thick. But you ain't tripping because, you know, it's you and your boys. And you feel like, you know, anything pops off, we already know what it is. Square biz. Boom, boom, bam. Excuse me. So the DJ says, all right. I see y'all out there. All my ladies in the building. The ladies in the building. My fellas in the building. Fellas in the building. All right. All right, we got the north side in the building. See, first of all, pause. Why do you need to know that? Why? Everything was fine. And it isn't, it's just like anything south, wherever you are, it's rough. Like, so then it's like, do we got the south and south side in the village, in the building? Oh, shit. Why are you asking these questions, sir? We don't need to. And then it's like, shit, you know that they don't get along. Do we got the east in the building? Oh, not the east. Are they here too? Wait, I just wanted to do the funky Y2C. I just came to do the Tootsie Roll. Hi, DJ, before you ask if the west is in the building, could I just please, I'm just begging you not to ask that because, did somebody just hit me with a flyer? Sir, please, could you not fucking call roll? Everything was fine. No, I've got dance moves that I nailed at home that I plan on busting tonight and being the one to, like, bring this whole club thing to its whole pinnacle. And here you are asking if the north, south, east, and I believe you're fucking trying to ask if the west is in the building. Why? Why are you doing that? Is this your first time DJing? Are you feeling that good that you want to ask these questions? Is this an interview? Just fucking turn the tables. Do the ones and twos. Scooch, scooch, scooch. Do all of that. Get your Bismarck key, Kid Capri on and just leave. Could you just do the DJ Eddie F thing and just fucking leave this where it's at? Why do you feel the need to have these niggas in here start wiping each other down? No, oh, watch out. Did you not see that coming? Now you see what I'm saying? You see that lump on your head? You haven't even fucking gotten into the west part of this. And these niggas is in here fighting already. And do you see this shit? Somebody just fucking pull my braid. This is your fault. No, if you would have just fucking played the damn playlist and left everything alone, we wouldn't even be in this shit. Now there is chaos and calamity because you wanted to fucking know who was in the building. You know what I'm saying? Do you understand what I'm saying? How you can incite a riot by simply asking who the fuck do we have in the building tonight? People. Duh. We have people in the building, like dancers in the building. We've got chillers in the building. Yeah, there's some killers in the building, but let's not poke the sleeping bear. These niggas isn't here. They trying to just chill. And you, for some reason, want to unchill them, unthaw these niggas, and cause chaos and calamity. It's something about repping your set in the club that causes all kind of fuckery. Now, everybody's headed to the door. Why is everybody headed to the door? Because of the DJ. I'm putting it all on you. No, everybody's literally headed to the door because they don't want to be in the midst of what's happening. And then in the midst of that, you hear somebody saying, I'll set this whole bitch off. Oh, wait. Excuse me, sir. I don't know where you're from. It's not my business. I don't want to know. It's his fault. But I know that you said that you'll set this whole bitch off. Just before you do that, I just want to leave. That's all I want to do. I just want to go home at this point because everything is fucked off. I can't dance. I can't show my braids off. I can't show my new outfit. Nothing. Because you feel the need now because of the DJ, okay, because it's all him, projecting everything onto him. He asked the question. I just want to go home. Don't set this bitch off just yet. And I really don't want you to set this bitch off at all because I'm not for chaos and calamity. But since it looks like you're going to, because I can really see the snarls, the grimace is real shit. Like, I can tell you're with this shit for real. just wait, just let me get through this door. And just let me get to my car, if you don't mind. Yeah. Before you guys spill out into the street with this shit, do you mind if we kind of like get through? No, actually, I need to go to coat check before you actually set this bitch off. Yeah, it's cold. It was like 65 degrees when I pulled in. I'm not a thought. I've been delivered from that. I'm not a bop. So I actually came with a coat. Anyways, just before you set this bitch off, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to get to these doors. That's what I'm going to do. I feel like this. I'm negotiating the fact this is a negotiation because I feel like I'm being held hostage now. I don't want to be with this whole club and chaos and calamity. This, none of this. No, fuck it. I don't ever want to come to a club again because every time people go out, they have to go right back out because y'all want to set shit off in the club. And it's dangerous. And we're all running to this door and it's causing a stampede. It's causing people to get crushed. It's causing people to end up really breaking bones. And it can cause someone to die because in this club is too much tension. In this club is too much beef. In this club is too much unresolved issues. In this clubs are people who are dedicated to where they're from. They rep where they're from. And anybody can get it that's not from their side. There is a lot of unfinished business in here between females. There are females in this club that are having sex with the same dudes that are coming to the club tonight. That are in the club tonight. There's a lot of beef. There are baby mamas of the same baby daddy in the club tonight. It's real shit. And females can get the shit popped off too, okay? Females come in there on 1 million too. You females who, look, you pack 15 deep in your grandma's cutlass and you roll to the club with your fresh $29.99 bundles, listen, you lurk and you seek whom you may devour and you start shit on purpose. There are people who go to the club and to the concerts to start shit on purpose. And this is a problem, okay? This is a problem because nobody wants to come out anymore. It doesn't matter who you have on the flyer. People don't want to come to the club anymore. It's getting that anorexic in the party scene because who wants to go to the party scene in a fresh Versace, fresh Gucci, whatever you put on, okay, whatever your garments are. Who wants to go to the club only to leave in a body bag? That shit ain't hot. Got your toes done, now you got a toe tag on your French manicure, on your white tips. I mean, on your white toes. Just think about it. You don't know, you catching bullets standing in line trying to get in because niggas feel like pulling up and just saying, hey, let's just go ahead, roll down the window, let's pull out this AK-47 that we have, and let's just spray everybody in line because we are really with the shit and we're demons. That's the chaos and calamity. Just even standing in line, you can get popped. That's a problem. If you say it's not, then you work for Beelzebub. Okay, you can never make it make sense. You tell me, why would anybody feel like, damn, we got an AK-47, let's just drive by and shoot people. And the next thing you know, a 16-year-old, a 20-year-old, a 27-year-old, a 42-year-old, a 56-year-old has now been murked, you know, killed, murdered by somebody who just felt like shooting up the club, literally. East Coast, West Coast, South, North, it don't matter where you from. The club scene is the same. It's grimy, it's dangerous, and it's enter at your own risk. And that's real shit. And don't let it be a performance, a club performance. You know what I'm saying? Now you're trying to go past capacity. Now it's a danger. It's all kind of things because people just want that money. You know? They don't care about the dangers as long as we can get that money at the door. And that's real. And it's a problem. And so now you're getting your money at the door, so that's all that you care about. You don't care about anything else. The security, nothing. All you all care about is who you can mac on, what numbers you can get, and how you can be seen. Boisterous, flamboyant, how everybody can see you. Some of you club promoters, some of you people who have these events, you don't even know what you're doing. You have no idea. All you care about is the money and the honey. That's it. And you looking at the niggas funny because you really just doing it so you can bring the ladies in. You don't really give a damn. You don't care. You don't care if it puts people in danger. Some of you literally, like literally, be having y'all events in the trenches. Y'all niggas be having y'all parties in the sewer. Like, yeah, come to club sewer. And you want to know why only rats show up. You know what I'm saying? Look where you be having your events. Look at the location. Look at the music that you play. And you want to know why shit pops off. And now you want to know why the city says you can never, ever, ever have a party again. You are done, Mr. Party Promoter. Some of you even promote club parties, you know, clubs, and you put people on the flyer that are not fucking coming. They were never coming. As a matter of fact, they don't know anything about this shit. And you just be luring people in. You put all these women on the flyers and not a none of the females that walk through that door or even crawl through that door or even fly through that door look anything like the women that you have on your flyer. It was all a dream. No, it was all a nightmare. Damn it. And you want to know why niggas don't come to your parties? Because the women on the flyer that you say are going to be at the club ain't at the club. They've never been at any of your events. Because look at where you have your events. Look at the energy that you possess. Those are the type of people that you attract to your function. And that low vibrating fuckboy energy, that low vibrating fuckgirl energy, and beef in the streets and all that shit, that's why your clubs have chaos. And that's why your clubs have calamity. That's why your events are far few and in between. It's just real shit. You need to know it. You need to stop having false advertisement on your flyers. None of these people is finna be here. And you know that. Ooh, I'm gonna get them with this one. LL Cool J is not finna be at your party. Boy, police 18 and up. And LL Cool J just out of nothing on a Friday night. Just said, yeah, I'm going to come to Club Sewer and I'm going to perform. Are you for real? You need to quit playing with people. Okay? Some of you will even put somebody who's not even alive on the flyer. That's how out of touch. You don't care. You just trying to draw them in. Ooh, girl, they said Tupac finna be at the at Club Sewer. Girl, for real? Yeah, he on the flyer, girl. Tupac finna be there. Girl, you know we finna be there. I knew he was alive. Girl, I'm going. Girl, we going. Tupac finna be there. Ooh. Ooh. You guys just bait them in. Bait them in. Some of you have no business having events at all. You suck at what you do. You're all in it for the money. You owe people money. You aren't giving people what they're owed. And it's just a whole calamity because you're not all the way tapped in. You're not even tapped in at all. And you're creating a problem. You're creating chaos and calamity every time you hold or host an event. We're going somewhere with this. Excuse me for coughing. We're going somewhere with this. So as we venture into the concerts, you know, and me having, I've gone to so many concerts. What I know now versus what I know then. Let me explain something to you. Real shit. I don't do crowds. I don't do crowds. And if I go to an event, it's because I have done a lot of praying. The biggest crowd I've been to as of recent is going to comedy clubs and went to some, a concert. Outside of that, if I'm not VIP, if I'm not front row, if I'm not backstage, I'm not going. I don't want to walk in through the normal lines. I don't want to stand in line. I'm VIP. Period. So Sister Speak is not going to do the regular. That's no diss to anybody else, but I just know who I am and my energy and who I am. I'm a treasure. I just have to go in a different way. I have to be able to not be so close to people in that way because I feel energy serious. and I don't trust energies, and I don't trust the host of the energies. I'm not going to put myself on purpose in danger. I am aware now that the places that I used to go to, I was putting myself in danger, and it was deadly. I was hanging out in clubs and going to concerts that I got out of by the grace of God, the Most High God. I've had to run. For real, like a Negro to the North. I had to hightail it out of there, like, for real. So the demonic energy is real. And I'm going to play these clips, and then I'm going to say what I have to say, and then we're going to end the show. I got you. Y'all ready? Now, you know I have you, right? Everything is for educational purposes only, for entertainment purposes only, under the Fair Use Act, to educate my people about stampedes, crowds, the science of it, okay? To raise awareness of just certain events that have occurred as a result of crowds, the deadly and the dangerous events, as a result of the chaos and calamities in the clubs and concerts. These things do not have to happen, but they do. And they happen for more than just what meets the eye. And if you're not tapped in, if you are allergic to wisdom, to knowing what a principality is, what spiritual wickedness is, if you do not believe in the devil, okay? And if you do not believe that the Most High God and Yah are real, super rule, period, then you're in trouble. If you don't believe in witchcraft, black magic, voodoo, I didn't say practice it. I said believe, knowing that it exists, knowing that people play with it, knowing that people literally sell their souls. If you don't believe any of that, you are in drama. You are in danger. You are in lava. The danger zone. I question your motives. I question who you are. I question who sent you, and we return to sender. Because most people who say, nah, you're not tapped in. You haven't received downloads. You have no intuition, no discernment. You don't get prophetic dreams. So you downplay something that you just have not been privileged to know. And so then when you hear the curriculum, when you hear the teaching, you shun it. You shy away from it. You try to denounce it. You try to say that it is bad when it is good. And then you try to say it is good when it is bad. You know what the fuck is really going on. Anybody who says that it is something that it is not is a liar. You are the type that call elephants tigers, giraffes bears, snakes turtles. You will not identify what it really is. You'd rather have a synonym for it versus what it is. You want to sugarcoat what it is. You want to walk away from it because maybe Beelzebub is your daddy. Maybe you are a child of the dark. Maybe you are a son and daughter of Satan. That's why you want to try to downplay what it really is. Because you know secretly, maybe allegedly, he's taking you to the mountaintop and offered you the world. Has he? Are you willing to actually forsake your birthright for a temporary moment of fuckery, chaos, and calamity, you better understand something. You either worship the Most High and Yah, or you worship Beelzebub. And people do some wicked things. You better activate. Get your scuba gear on, and I'll see you. Well, I won't see you. I will converse with you on the other side of these clips. I thank you for being a wonderful listening audience. I really appreciate you.
At 1 a.m., 45 people were killed and 150 more were injured in a stampede during a religious festival in Israel. Human stampedes have been a chronically understudied topic, but there has been an uptick in reported stampedes as populations have increased. It's a topic that deserves more attention. In this video, we're going to find out how these tragedies occur. Of course, crowd psychology is a big factor, but design is often the real problem. Human stampedes have likely occurred throughout human history. But with the rise of densely packed urban areas in the 1800s, recorded stampedes increased. Take the 1896 coronation of Tsar Nicholas II. Rumors spread that the concession stands were running out of souvenirs, and 1,000 people died. Incidents like this have only become more common. Between 1980 and 2007, 216 stampedes occurred worldwide, resulting in 7,000 deaths and twice that many injuries. And there has been a steady rise in reported stampedes since the 1990s. Now, on average, they claim the lives of 380 people every year. As you can see from this chart of the deadliest stampedes of all time, religion draws the biggest crowds. After that, sports and festivities. But what actually qualifies as a stampede? It's more rigorous of a standard than you might think. Researchers define a stampede, also called a crowd crush, as an impulsive mass movement of a crowd that often results in injuries and deaths. But what you might not know is that there's a critical density at which this kind of disaster becomes likely to occur, and it's about 10 people per square meter. If you're not able to touch anyone standing next to you, density is probably around 3 people per square meter. If you're unintentionally bumping into one or two people, it's probably climbed to 4 or 5. If you can't raise your hands to touch your face, it's probably about 10, and that's a big issue. There's two types of stampedes, unidirectional and turbulent. Unidirectional stampedes will flow in one direction until they encounter an obstacle. The other kind of stampede is a turbulent one, when people are trying to go a bunch of different directions, or crowds from two different directions collide. While you might think that turbulent stampedes sound more chaotic and therefore dangerous, that's not the case. Unidirectional stampedes have been hypothesized to be much more dangerous. After all, 6 or 7 people pushing in one direction have enough force to bend steel railings. We know that significant injuries occur because of stampedes, but we don't know much about the specifics. Data on the injured from hospitals, even something as basic as an accurate count of fatalities, often doesn't exist. The most common misconception is that most people die when they fall down and are trampled, but that's actually not the case. Many people die standing up as the pressure on their rib cages from the crowd literally suffocates them. Autopsies of people who suffocated in stampedes show pressures as high as 6.4 psi exerted on the chest. And while humans can withstand 50 psi at an impact, the slow, relentless pressure is more than enough to squeeze you to death. You'd think when people see others being hurt like this, they'd stop and help each other. Also, not the case. When a psychological trigger, like a rumor sweeping through a crowd or a loud noise goes off, it can cause panic in an already anxious crowd. Or sometimes, there are just way too many people. But none of that is deadly, if the location is right. Oftentimes, news reports blame crowds for what are actually failures of planning and logistics. old infrastructure that wasn't built with crowd safety in mind generally has smaller entry and exit points, thin stairwells, and tall permanent barriers. Compare that to a modern stadium like SoFi Stadium in Los Angeles, which can hold 70,000 people. Check out these wide doorways, clear and well-marked exits, and gently sloped stairwells. When architecture isn't designed to hold large, rowdy crowds, people can succumb to mass behavior or mimicking what other people do. When they see others panicking, they panic too, and the panic exponentially increases as people keep mimicking each other's emotions. Pressure points can build with the panic in these areas, and they look something like this. The design causes of crowd stampedes are tight bottlenecks, clogged exits, alternative exits that are overlooked in a panic, and difficult access points. Saudi Arabian officials in particular have made a real effort to redesign their pilgrimage destinations. After a stampede in 2006, Saudi authorities built single direction pathways, started visitor counts, and offered timed tickets. Another Saudi pilgrimage destination, the Jamard Bridge, was the site of a stampede that killed over 1,000 people in 2015. Now, it's a multi-level, multi-exit complex designed to keep people moving. Most researchers are in agreement. To prevent stampedes, you have to redesign the locations. To learn more about these little understood events, scientists are turning to cell phone data and social media. But crowd modeling is only as effective as the theories it's based on, and it's incredibly hard to predict or model human behavior. It's not effective to assume people will panic in a certain area because it's so dependent on a psychological trigger. So we can hope that if you're ever caught in a stampede, it's in a location that's been properly designed for crowd safety. But is there anything that you personally can do? Psychologist John Drury from the University of Sussex has proven that altruism and mutual assistance are key to avoiding tragedy in emergencies. When people in a crowd stop and help each other instead of succumbing to individual panic, significant injuries and deaths may be prevented. So keep an eye out for the designs of the future. And in the meantime, make sure you're watching out for your fellow man, even if you haven't been evolved to do it.
I'm Josh Clark, and you are you, and that is wonderful. Let's talk about crowd crushes. So have you ever been standing in a crowd before? Say you were waiting for a Weird Al to come out from backstage after a show, and then suddenly he does, and all of a sudden it seems like all the people around you multiply exponentially, and as far as you can see, you're surrounded by people, and all of them start to press forward, and you, against your own will, are propelled forward. And you're pushed into the person in front of you, and you propel them forward, and you stop and think, uh-oh. Well, if you thought that, you were thinking very clearly, because you were in a very dangerous situation, something called a high-density crowd. A high-density crowd is one where there's six or more people per square meter, and it can get a lot more packed than that, but that's the lowest level threshold. And the reason that's the threshold is because when you have six people per square meter, individuals in the crowd start to lose their ability to move on their own accord. Things get more and more packed, and the crowd tends to behave a lot like a fluid. So there's a couple of ways that you can actually die in a high-density crowd. The first one's called a crowd crush. Now, when you first start to get to about six people per square meter, the individuals lose their ability to move around. The next step is that you lose your ability to move your arms from your sides. And as people pack in further and further, the pressure from all sides keeps your lungs from inflating and deflating, which means you lose your ability to breathe. What's amazing and horrific is that people suffocate in crowds because they're squeezed so tightly by the people pressing against them. That's a crowd crush. Another way you can die in a crowd is what's called progressive crowd collapse. So say you have a bunch of people crowded together in a high density crowd, and one of them falls down. That creates a hole in this crowd, and the people who were formerly leaning against the person who just fell down start to fall over, and so on and so forth, and a domino effect is created. People start to pile up, and the ones on bottom are literally pressed to death by the humans who have piled up on top of them. So why don't people just get up and go? Get out of the crowd? Well, the short answer is they can't. One mark for humanity is that crowd researchers have shown that when individuals are given information, say something like, oh, someone ahead is being crushed to death, they respond positively by, say, backing up and alleviating the pressure on the crowd in front. The problem is humans aren't ants. We don't transmit information through crowds like ants do, and so people end up dying in crowd crushes and progressive crowd collapses because the people in the back are pushing forward. Another common misconception are mass panics and stampedes. So there's this idea that people stampede over one another, and that's how deaths occur in crowd crushes. This is really off point. In fact, if you have enough room to run roughshod over your fellow humans to get from point A to point B, there's probably enough room for those fellow humans to get out of the way. So stampedes really don't cost any lives whatsoever. That's not the problem with crowd crushes. And the same with mass panics. Very rarely do entire crowds panic and move in a panicked way. In fact, you can suffocate in a crowd crush in a very calm crowd that's just entered a bottleneck in a narrow corridor and trying to get out of an exit. People just quietly die, pinned up against their fellow human beings who are leaving the place. So crowd researchers are using computers now to predict high-density crowds and stop them before they turn fatal. They're using video feeds fed into artificial intelligence, which analyze crowds for things like increases in body heat or people swaying from side to side, which is a telltale sign that they're no longer moving on their own volition. So what do you do if you find yourself in a crowd? Well, get out. That's the best thing you can do. But as you're entering a crowd, crowd researchers suggest that you pay attention, stop talking, and listen ahead for people calling for help or saying move back or any other indication that there's a crowd crush going on. In that case, get back as far as you can. If you find yourself in a crowd and it starts to surge forward, follow the crowd movement, but move to the side as much as possible. Just stay out of crowds. How about that? Have you ever been in a crowd crush or a crowded situation where you thought, uh-oh? Let us know in the comments section below. And while you're down there, go ahead and subscribe.
Man, it's like you got a show, and especially my shit, you need to be sweating, you know, like some type of steam, raging. You know, you just gotta live life, man.
And it ain't no mosh pit if ain't no injuries. I got a stage diving, nothing knows bleeds.
While moshing is part of the appeal for some fans, it's not without its hazards, ranging from a bloody nose to some broken limbs. But we wanted to dig deeper and understand what makes people want to mosh.
I think the draw of moshing, which is very exciting to look at, especially, again, remember, mostly young males. Young males are risk takers.
That's Paul Wertheimer, a crowd safety expert and CEO of CrowdSafe. He spent the last 20 years researching moshing from inside the pit, and he told us that there's more to it than meets the eye.
There's crowd surfing. There used to be stage diving by fans. There's a slam pit. There's all kinds of things going on.
While moshing has definitely evolved over time, one thing has stayed the same. For many concertgoers, it's kind of an emotional release.
Mostly young males with a lot of energy take maybe their frustrations by being really aggressive.
Though moshing can be violent, it also gives participants a sort of safe space where that kind of aggression and physical contact is allowed and often encouraged.
You share that excitement if everybody likes the music of the artist. So it's a communal experience. It's physical, it's consensual physical contact.
Despite its massive popularity at rap shows today, the origins of moshing date back to punk shows of the late 70s and early 80s.
Well, it comes from the idea of the slam pits of the 80s, of the punk underground punk scene, where people would dance around, throw their arms up, throw their legs up, bounce into people.
They're not out there to hurt each other. They're out there getting their aggressions out. I mean, they got a lot of pent-up angers and hates and frustrations, and like a lot of things about the world to piss them off, and it's just a release.
Early punk, hardcore, and metal bands almost always had some form of moshing, slam dancing, or stage diving at their shows. But back then, for true fans, it was considered an art form.
Hardcore was about the band and the kids are equal. And that's why slam dancing was okay. That's why stage diving was okay, because you were really at one with the band.
By the 1990s, this style of dancing and moshing at shows slowly became more mainstream, thanks to the emergence of grunge.
But it got really physical, consistently physical, with the grunge scene out of Seattle, because of the mixture of heavy metal and punk culture. I mean, remember in 1994, a lot of bands saw moshing at Woodstock that never saw it before.
Until this point, moshing had been largely absent from traditional hip-hop shows.
Early Ice Cube, Ice-T, back in the days, back in the 90s, where it was mostly gang members showing up. You didn't touch anybody, especially if you were white. You didn't touch anybody, period.
But things changed when rap groups like Onyx started incorporating mosh pits into their own concerts and music videos.
We got the chorus from Nirvana, Smells Like Teen Spirit. That's where the idea came from.
We wanted to have black people, hip hop,
go crazy,
slam dancing in the in the gym just like that.
Rap has a great following, has for decades, among white youth. Slam dancing could take off if the crowd was mostly like that.
But now things are different.
We culture. Rap is the new rock and roll. We the rock stars.
Countless hip-hop acts have incorporated moshing into their live acts and music videos.
We mosh because artists want to see us active and give back to them the feelings, the emotion they're trying to communicate with us with their music.
But there's also a dark side.
It's hitting other people. It's knocking people over. It depends. It can be very violent, and it can be bloody, and it can be deadly.
In late 2017, Travis Scott was sued by a fan who was paralyzed following his show in New York City.
To the baseline. They gonna catch you. Don't be scared. Don't be scared.
And back in 2014, Tyler, the Creator, was arrested for inciting a riot at his show at South by Southwest.
Right now. Let's do it. Let's go.
The guy who or woman who controls the mic controls the crowd to a large extent. And if your favorite artist tells you to do something, you're not going to think about whether this is smart or not.
But for now, it seems moshing, stage diving, and crowd surfing aren't going anywhere anytime soon. And crowds are still going to get hyped for their favorite artists however they can. But Paul still had some advice as a veteran of the pit.
It's a lot of fun. I mean, the fact is, moshing can be a lot of fun. You don't feel comfortable in a crowd, get out. While you can. Don't feel like you're a weakling. Just get out and get to a safe place.
I'm Tia with Genius News, bringing you the meaning and the knowledge behind the music. We'll be right back after these commercial breaks. You are listening to The Tour on the Sister Speak Show, where we cover all aspects of the music industry. Juicy, ain't it? Okay. Juicy, Minute Maid. We'll be right back.
The latest episode of The Laugh Line on the Sister Speak Show is available on demand now. On this episode, can you take the heat? The origin of the comedy roast. Do some jokes go too far? Plus, naturally funny, Desi Banks, and on tour again, must-see comedians. On The Laugh Line, we are covering all aspects of comedy for all shades of brown people. You will not be disappointed. This episode is rated R for strong language, thoughts, and ideas. It's time to what? Podcast and chill with the Sister Speak Show, where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action, a talk show for great minds that create, inspire, impact, and evolve. Click the link in the bio for this episode. It's time to get lit, laugh, learn, and live.
All right, brothers and sisters, here's part two of Deadly and Dangerous. When Chaos and Calamity Strikes Concerts and Clubs. Man down.
Yep. 45 people were killed and 150 more.
Wait a minute. Here we go.
Overnight chaos in the streets. Kanye West fans flock to a rumored pop-up concert in a Manhattan neighborhood, and things quickly get way out of control. Good morning, everyone. I'm Chris Rangi.
And I'm Andrea Grimes. Mary Calvi has the day off, and we begin with that breaking news. Chaos in the East Village as thousands gathered for a rumored performance by Kanye West.
Yeah, the rapper making an appearance but never really taking the stage. CBS 2's Magdalena Doris is live outside of Webster Hall with more this morning. Magdalena.
Good morning, Chris and Andrea. Yes, the show never got started, but when Kanye West made a fleeting appearance outside, hundreds of people erupted, running through the streets and effectively shutting down the neighborhood. Thousands of people crowding Third Avenue this morning, all converging on Webster Hall, waiting and sprinting at times for a chance to see Kanye West.
I personally saw kids trampling windshields of cars. It was surreal. It was honestly something that should never happen, and it just spiraled out of control.
The hip-hop superstar was scheduled to perform at a rained-out governor's ball on Sunday. Somehow, through word of mouth, it was rumored he'd be performing at a pop-up concert at Webster Hall, a venue which holds 1,500 people at capacity. Thousands showed up spilling out onto 3rd Avenue. When a message by Webster Hall was tweeted there was no concert, that's when witnesses say the crowd of thousands flowing out onto the street got out of control.
We just saw a black Mercedes-Benz pulling up and a whole bunch of people running, so we ran over to the car and it's Kanye West standing out of the roof of the Mercedes-Benz and Travis Scott coming out of the window.
In this Snapchat video, you can see Kanye West hanging out of a car to greet those waiting for him.
You know how crazy it is out there. Like, why would you come down here and, like, stir it up more?
Now multiple cars parked along East 11th Street are dented and damaged, unable to withstand the weight of excited fans jumping on the roofs to get a look.
If the concert had happened, this would have never happened.
Police cited one person for disorderly conduct. Now, a lot of this started on social media when that pop-up concert was rumored to announce Kim Kardashian, Kanye West's wife, now making an announcement on Snapchat saying they apologized, they tried the best they could, but the police just would not let this happen. We're live in the East Village. Magdalena Doris, CBS 2 News.
Yeah, it's the cops' fault.
Please, everybody, stop. Remain calm. Remain calm. Try and open up the fence in the back, and we'll try and get the people out.
And I'm looking at a woman that
Easter Island is known for its stone.
I don't know what's going on.
Sir, you know what's going on? Okay. Ma'am, you know what's going on? All right. Okay, I'm staying right here. Yes, ma'am.
Pat, move that chair right here.
We started running out of that line.
Please, everybody, remain calm. Try and move backwards. Don't push forward. Try and exit back.
During the concert, patrons were standing outside of the business when a white SUV pulled up, where three subjects stepped out of the vehicle with assault rifles and handguns and began shooting indiscriminately into the crowd, of which we believe is a targeted act of gun violence. Unfortunately, multiple people were shot. As of right now, we have 20 to 25 victims at various hospitals around the community, as well as two deceased victims on the scene. This is a despicable act of gun violence, a cowardly act. We have our investigators on the scene. We're asking for any information from the community. Anyone who has any tips on these individuals, please give it to us, 305-471. Tips. This type of gun violence has to stop. Every weekend it's the same thing. This is targeted. This is definitely not random. My condolences to the families and to the victims. That's all I have right now. As we get more information, we'll provide it for you.
Director, what runs through your mind? We had seven, I believe, shot yesterday in Wynwood. Now we have this. I mean, like you said, it just seems like every weekend it seems to be some sense of gun violence.
It's very disheartening, but it's a trend that you're seeing around the country. Just yesterday in the news, we were talking about expecting a violent summer, and unfortunately, Miami-Dade County is not immune to that. The good thing here, our law enforcement community and our community at large are engaged. We're working really hard, but it's very difficult to stop a small amount of individuals who want to go out there and commit murder. And it takes all of us to stop this, and we really have to put the work in this summer to keep our children and our community safe.
Oh my God.
I don't know where she is.
Panicking, screaming, shouting, crying.
These are kids.
There are no words.
We'll all go to bed, holding our little ones even tighter this evening.
No official word yet if Ariana will cancel her world tour, as dozens of families in Manchester continue to search for missing loved ones, and photos of some of the estimated 22 fatalities have emerged. The singer was spotted for the first time today being comforted by her boyfriend, Mac Miller, stepping off a private plane in Florida. Silent since her statement last night on Twitter, Ariana admits she's now broken. From the bottom of my heart, I'm so sorry. I don't have words. Family friend Ryan Seacrest confirmed this morning that she is being looked after by family.
I spoke to her manager, Scooter, so she's with family, and, you know, I think that there's a lot of question. There's some anger.
Rapper Bia, who opened the concert, tweets, "My heart is heavy today as I extend my prayers to the children and families affected by last night's horrible tragedy in Manchester."
Police raids are now ongoing across the UK city as ISIS claims responsibility for the terror attack.
Earlier this morning, a 23-year-old man was arrested, and the suicide bomber, a 22-year-old man we are choosing not to name, was confirmed dead at the scene.
Police carried out a controlled explosion to gain access to a property in Manchester this afternoon. Global News reporter Jeff Semple is on location near the arena where the attack took place.
Everyone still being kept well away from the Manchester Arena, which is about half a kilometer down the road here behind me. It is Europe's largest indoor arena, can seat around 21,000 people. And over the years, it has played host to some pretty impressive acts. Many of those musicians and performers have been paying tribute, posting on social media, expressing their shock and horror, and giving their condolences to the victims of last night's attacks, including some musicians who are from right here in Manchester. Harry Styles, Gary Barlow, and Oasis legend Liam Gallagher, who posted on Twitter himself saying that he is in shock and absolutely devastated to hear the news of such an awful attack striking the heart of his hometown.
Across the English Channel, security in Cannes is on high alert, with celebrities at the French Film Festival still in shock.
My daughter is 9. If this concert had been in the UK, she would have been there. With or without me. If I was here and it was happening there, she would have gone with the friends and the mom. She would have been there. And it's this is one of the reasons why I have not slept.
Human beings have always done despicable things in the name of faith or belief.
To have it be focused on children is phenomenally disgusting. Like, I don't even know how to respond to it.
It's devastating. Devastating. And for the families that are going through this now, it's not even to be discussed. It's just to be pray for them.
In New York, the cast of Baywatch paid tribute to the victims.
My heart goes out to everyone out there, and I hope she's okay, and I hope that her fans and everyone involved is all right.
Those are kids, mostly like, you know, young kids.
And Katy Perry, a fellow pop star with a young fan base, is calling for unity on the Elvis Duran Show.
I just feel devastated. I think that the greatest thing we can do is just unite and love on each other, and like, no barriers, no borders. Like, we all need to just coexist. Ari's fans are my fans, and my fans are Ari's fans, and like, we're just all loving on each other.
When something is Latinx created, it just...
Hours after releasing surveillance video showing a man firing a gun at a hip-hop concert in New York, police have arrested a suspect in connection with a deadly shooting. Brooklyn rapper Roland Collins was arrested Thursday on attempted murder and weapons charges, with more charges possible. Authorities say Ronald McFadder was killed and three others wounded in the shooting, including Collins, who was shot in the leg.
I'm not going to stop until I get justice for my son. And finally, his death will not be in vain.
Police say a fight broke out in a performer's lounge of Manhattan's Irving Plaza concert hall and spilled out into a second-story VIP balcony Wednesday night. Rapper T.I. was set to perform.
T.I. was present at the location. This was prior to his performance. These were the opening acts, from what I can understand, Mano and Uncle Murder. Again, we're just trying to tap that down as we go forward. He doesn't appear to be involved in this in any way.
Authorities say they are trying to determine how someone brought a gun past security, something the victim's family also wants to know.
There was metal detection there. There was a security force there. We're trying to determine if anybody defeated that area. But, you know, sometimes the acts come in with things we don't know yet.
I need to know who's on staff and how they got in there with them guns.
That's right.
Accountability.
That's right.
The victim's family says McFadder was working as Collins' bodyguard.
Krista Fourier, Associated Press.
From Taiwan water park fire as one victim is pronounced dead. A tragic explosion occurred at a Color Play Asia party on Saturday at the Formosa water park in New Taipei City, Taiwan, leaving 498 partygoers with serious burns. 202 of the victims are in critical condition, and one 20-year-old woman who was in attendance has died from injuries sustained from the explosion and resulting fire. The fireball was caused when flammable colored powder that was being sprayed out into the crowd ignited from an unknown heat source. Investigators hypothesized that the fire could have been initially caused by either the heat from the stage lights, someone smoking a cigarette, or a spark in the crowd. The organizer of the event and two technicians were arrested in response to the accident and have since been released on bail. The organizer of the party, Liu Chongqi, has taken full responsibility for the accident. The only death reported so far is a 20-year-old woman who was taken off of life support on Monday after suffering second-degree burns to 90% of her body. In the aftermath of the explosion, colored powder has been banned from parties, as doctors are worried that some partygoers inhaled the powder, which may cause respiratory problems. Skin grafts are being reallocated from around Taiwan to assist with the large number of burn victims at Mackie Memorial Hospital in Taipei. The water park has subsequently closed out of respect for the victims while an investigation is ongoing.
Leave an insightful comment on Tom.
Death gunfire, AK-47 in Las Vegas at a concert.
There were actually two separate shooting incidents, all after a rap concert at a local nightclub. Four gunshot victims and a police officer was injured. The first incident taking place this morning, this all happening before 2 a.m. A damaged van showed up at Elliott Hospital, and inside were four gunshot victims, their injuries non-life-threatening. Police say they're from New York, and they were in New Hampshire for a rap concert last night. They were shot while on I-293 after leaving the club. Police say they are looking for a white sedan, possibly a Dodge, involved in that drive-by shooting.
We received word from a Manchester police officer who was assigned to the Elliott on a detailed assignment that a van with multiple victims suffering gunshot wounds had arrived at the hospital. Officers responded to the hospital as well as the area around Jewel nightclub to investigate further.
And the chief talking about the Jewel nightclub incident, where an officer there heard a shot fired and then saw a blue vehicle taking off from the scene. After that pursuit, the car crashed and the two men inside were arrested. An officer ended up being injured when their vehicle actually hit the officer's cruiser, but we're told that the officer is expected to be okay. Now, the two suspects are from Springfield, Massachusetts. They're expected to be arraigned this afternoon, and police are investigating whether these two incidents are connected. Live in Manchester, Sarah Congee, WCVB News Center.
Understand the woman at the center of this shooting, an innocent bystander, shot in front of the legendary Fox Theater in Oakland as she waited to meet band members before the concert.
It appears she was hit by a stray bullet. This comes at a heightened time of concern for Oakland after last weekend's tragic shooting of that little boy by a stray bullet on 880. Here's NBC Bay Area Cheryl Hurd.
Fans who came to see the band All Time Low disappointed tonight that the concert had to be canceled because of a shooting.
They're like one of my favorite bands, and I've kind of dreamt about this moment for like 5 years, so I'm really upset, but I hope everybody's okay.
The band's lead singer, also concerned, taking to Instagram to explain why they canceled the show.
Earlier today, a altercation took place down the street involving gunfire, and one person waiting in line for our show was hit by a stray bullet in the arm.
It happened just before 2:30, right across the street from the famed Fox Theater. Witnesses say the shooting stems from a running gun battle between someone trying to steal a car and the car owner.
I was in the parking lot, and I heard shots, like 10, 15.
Josephine Thompson, attending Oakland School for the Arts, says the campus was a refuge for people running for cover.
My principal, Mr. Oz, said that he let people in, I guess, who had been on the street or something, or maybe they were going to the show.
Police aren't saying what led up to the shooting. If police confirm it was a stray bullet, it comes just 4 days after 23-month-old Jasper Wu was shot dead, hit by a stray bullet while riding in the back seat of a car on 880 in Oakland. Gun violence is plaguing the city. Diane Garcia works for the Urban Strategies Council, where she focuses on violence prevention.
Finding a way to peacefully get the guns that are on the street off of the street. And I think that's going to take a lot of healing in the community.
Meanwhile, concert goers are being told to hang on to their tickets. The band may reschedule this concert, or they may give their fans a refund. In Oakland, Cheryl Hurd, NBC Bay Area News.
FBI opens up about the fatal shooting that occurred at his concert in NYC.
I want to ask you kind of a serious thing that happened at your concert. There was a fatal shooting. Mm-hmm. Can you kind of go back to that and tell me what was going through your mind when that happened?
I mean, just getting everybody with me somewhere safe.
Yeah.
Yeah, I am too.
The 35-year-old rapper previously shared his condolences with those affected by last month's shooting on his Instagram account, writing, "My heart is heavy today. Our music is intended to save lives, like it has mine and many others. My heartfelt condolences to the family that suffered the loss, and my prayers are with all those injured." The altercation took place in the green room on the third floor of Irving Plaza and left one man dead and three wounded. Rapper Roland Collins, who goes by the stage name Troy Ave, was among the injured and has been arrested in connection with the shooting. He's charged with attempted murder and criminal possession of a weapon and has pleaded not guilty. A bail hearing is set for July.
Investigators are trying to figure out what went wrong at the Astroworld Festival, and they're looking into Travis Scott's past concerts, too. The Astroworld First Fest headliner and rap star faced heavy criticism in the past for his concert safety, fans being injured. He was even arrested for inciting a riot at a concert back in 2017. Ileana Diaz joining us now live from the Hard Rock Stadium in Miami Gardens, where Scott performed this past summer. Ileana.
Adrian, Travis Scott's concerts are known for high energy, for large crowds, and for lots of stage diving. And this time around in Houston, all of the chaos started before the festival even started. As soon as the gates opened, people were rushing through the doors and knocking over barricades. And this is now the third time one of his concerts has ended in an investigation.
Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to click on the red subscribe button below so you can get more of News Nation's fact-driven, unbiased coverage.
Welcome back. You are listening to The Tour on the Sister Speak Show. I'm your host, Sister Speak. The Tour, where we cover all aspects of the music industry. You know, I like what I do and I do what I do well. And I wanted to lead up to the recent event that occurred in Houston at Astroworld. And I gotta get into it, and I'm telling you now, some of you may not like what I'm getting ready to say, and I don't give a fuck. I don't give any cares about what I'm getting ready to say if it affects you in a way solely based on the fact that you worship the devil. Let's get it, let's go. No background music. Check this in. Why are you diving off of the stage? Why are you diving off of the stage? For what? For why? There's no point. There's nothing that anyone could ever tell me that would convince me that diving off of the stage is wise. you dive off of the stage and you're hoping that they catch you, and you want to crowd surf while people are grabbing on all parts of your body. And you are in a trance, assuming that this is what you're supposed to do. To my brothers who are from the village but have definitely not been back to the village in a long time, but you only come to the village to just, you know, check in, to gather the energy, why do you continue to try to be like the nations in what they do when they perform? What is it about what they do that has you so attracted to their darkness that you say, oh, I want to be dark as well, and I want to surf the crowd, and I want to have a mosh pit, and I want to incite this hideous energy that results in nothing but brutal combat, injury, death, extreme violence? Why? One of the mosh pitters said that there are so many angry males that are angry at the world that this is their place to get it out. To the world, this particular world. This particular world is run by society. Nobody has ever seen society, yet society is powerful with a lowercase p, and influences and makes suggestions of how you should vibrate. Society suggests that a male stay quiet and not express himself, hold in his tears, be a man, big boys don't cry, and you are to not cry out. You're not to say a word. You're supposed to internalize and hold in everything that you encounter in your journey. That is a lie from the devil. And this is a practice, excuse me, that has been occurring for a long time. This lack of communication and this wicked internalization of what is plaguing you on the inside. My brother, you're holding in years of pain. You're a musician, whether you're mainstream or independent, I'm speaking to you about the energy that you possess when you perform, when you record, when you are in front of your fan base. And the fact that you are unhealed on stage and you are suggesting and inciting energy that you possess and you want to see other people possess, or they already possess, and all this is one big pit of misery, bitter men, hurt men, confused men. Men who are so tormented on the inside that violence is the only remedy against each other. Getting in a pit, creating a pit, and then slam dancing and violently encountering one another. You cannot make that make sense. to the nations. Your sons, nephews, grandsons. Are wilding out. And they are responsible for a lot of the violence that occurs in this world. Moving to the stage, to my brothers, why are you trying to go so mainstream with your performing and with your music that you're tapping in to the dark side in order to sell your brand, your music, or whatever? And I can't even really call it music, because what the fuck are you saying? What the fuck are you even talking about? What the fuck was that bar? Why did you write that? Why did your ghostwriter write that? Why are you up here telling everybody to allegedly do things through your music? Why are you suggesting these low vibrating energies? Why? And you're a brother. You are a brother. Or did you forget? Do you want to be so famous, so known, go have a number one album to the point to where you're willing to walk away from the village and tap into the dark side? And your fan base is just as dark as you are. Allegedly, something else is going on. And allegedly, what it looks like is more than what it looks like. It's obvious that some of you brothers don't believe in the Most High God. You don't thank Him when you receive your awards. You thank God, but you don't thank the Most High God in Yah. You thank God. Whatever you are rapping about, wrap it up. Pack it up. Throw that shit away. What the fuck are you really talking about? Why are you trying to sell out the village, bro? Why are you putting the village in danger? Why the fuck are you suggesting these things to these young boys and these young girls? Why? And then when you get to your concerts, your energy attracts calamity and chaos. Excuse me. To the naked eye, to the blind eye, to the deaf ear, you did no wrong. You do no wrong. It's just a normal thing that can happen. And it can. Right. I laid out the history. I'm aware. I'm cognizant. But it's more than that. It's more than that. You know it. And I know. And let's just move me out the way. The Most High God knows it. He knows what you're doing, what you're tapped into, why you write what you write, why you perform what you perform, and who you channel. He's aware of everything that you do. You don't escape the truth. You may have the public fooled. You may have those who idolize you fooled. But in totality, what the fuck really happened at your concert? What happened? What really happened? And did you get what you were looking for? Did you benefit? I mean, did Did that which was hungry, was it fed? I would not suggest going to any concert where I'm walking through the fucking mouth of the musician. There's nothing amusing about that park. The parks I go to don't look like that. The amusement I'm seeking is not going through the mouth of a statue. What really happened? What was the real plan? Is the questions. But nobody can say anything, right? Do you tap into the dark side with your music? Is that who writes your lyrics? Are you in allegiance with the dark side when it comes to performing? A mosh pit, y'all. Stage diving. People crushed. Can't breathe. Running all over the place. Stampedes. Fentanyl being injected into people's necks. Lyrics that suggest that people lick the rocks in Hades, Sheol, Gehenna. That people vibrate low and act like ghouls and goblins and zombies and witches and warlocks. There's nothing that is upright about what you say when you get on the microphone. Whether lies were lost at this event, and lives were not lost at another event, but chaos and calamity still occurred. The whole point is, why is it happening? What is it about any artist, stepping outside of all shades of brown and saying within the nations or in even within the all shades of brown, what is it about what you do that creates danger? An outside concert, an inside concert, standing in line, being inside, it all is enter at your own risk. Who do you idolize and why do you have an idol? Do you know that's one of the worst things that you can have is an idol? Is somebody who you worship blindly and deathly? Someone who does not give zero F's about who you are at all. They just want your energy. That's all they want. It's your energy. Some of them. Allegedly. That's all they want. Are you giving up your energy? If they tell you to go this way, do you go? If they tell you to go that way, do you go? How deep are you into being a fan? Brother and sister, what is it about assimilating into the nations with your music? What is it? Some of you need to pack it all the way up and really just let it go. Your lyrics are fucking the village all the way up. What you do fucks the village up. It does not give the village any type of remedy. It just pollutes the village. You're toying with the devil. Damn it. He doesn't even give a fuck about you. Make that make any wisdom. You worship and you go to someone, a spirit that doesn't give a fuck about you. But you want to be number one on the charts. You want to be number one wherever you go. You want to be the one, and you're willing to do anything even incite chaos and calamity in order to collect a check and to provide energy so the beast can stay fed. I mean, everybody is not blind. There are people who are aware of what's really going on. Children shouldn't have been at that event. What's the bait? What is the bait? Did you not see the flyer and read it and see that there was going to be danger at this event? Some of you have actually come out and said, yeah, I worship the devil. And only thing I can say is TikTok. You know, that's probably one of the worst things you could have ever made a decision about. And you're not going to do well. And you're not doing well. Any event where you have to run for your life, you need to question, how bad do I want to get outside? How bad do I want to go see this artist? We're not living in a day and time where you can just go out and say, la, 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 la. This, no. This is not a day and age where you can just say, I just think I'm going to get some chalk. And I'm going to play hopscotch outside. Yeah, that's what it... Nah, this is not this... No. You cannot walk around in this world blind. And you need to question, why do I sing? Why do I rap? What the fuck do I sing about? What the fuck do I rap about? Go through your fucking... Listen, go through your journal, wherever it is, and read over your lyrics, please. Because many of you have put out so much garbage that is ridiculous. A lot of you are on one major label called Landfill Records and Entertainment. Toilet Bowl Records and Entertainment. Sewer System Records and Entertainment. Bullshit Records and Entertainment. Oh, I'm not done. For fucking what? Records and Entertainment. You get it? Do you get my boldness and bluntness about the fact that there is so much energy that people are listening to, and the energy is suggesting that we dysfunction, that we destroy, that we then come and be lured in, and that we be baited in, and that we actually participate in rituals, spell work, voodoo, black magic, and some people literally have no idea. Now, there are those who have risen and have walked into the download about music. Some of you, when the wisdom is brought to you, you say, I don't believe in that. You crazy. I don't believe in that. That's because maybe you haven't been chosen. We're going to have to start really letting people know what it is. Maybe you just haven't been chosen. There are some of you who will never walk away from Babylon. You have completely forsaken the village. Some of you want to assimilate into this industry by any means necessary. How many people's lives were lost at this last event? Everybody who went. What you saying, Sister Speak? Anybody who went to that event, their lives were lost before they even got there. That's how they ended up at that event. When you are without the Most High in Yah, you're in trouble. But I guess everybody just can't come. Because anybody who will go to an event like that, allegedly, you're actually entering to your own slaughter. Because yes, you may walk away from that event or not, but if you do walk away, what are you walking away with? What type of energy are you leaving with? How deeper into the abyss have you gone by actually coming where all those bodies are gathered to idolize this thing? Do you not understand that the spirit realm is real and that people play with some shit that they have no business playing with? You just don't get on. You just do not just get on. That's not how it works in this world. There are things that you have to do. And I guess some of you decided that you didn't matter. So you tapped out of your soul and said, fuck my soul. I don't give a fuck about my soul. I want this money. I want this fame. I want these chains. I want these diamonds. I want these bitches. I want these riches. I want these cars. I want this status. I want these followers. I want it all. I want it now. So fuck it. Here you go. I don't give a fuck about this. It's just a soul. Give me these riches and give me these bitches now. Oh yeah, that's what I'm talking about. That's what I want. Thank you. What do I have to do? What else? Oh, I gotta keep, okay, I gotta do, yeah. Let me explain something to you. Some of you celebrities, some of you, you wanna live a normal life so bad. You want to tap out so bad. You realize that you got into some shit that you should not have gotten into. And you have seen some shit that, ooh, you got to keep quiet about. And it's fucking real. And you would love to just have a normal day where you can be in hermit mode. Where you don't have to deal with the paparazzi, the blogs, the interviews going from city to city, state to state, country to continent. You just want to just sit the fuck down and have a normal fucking day. You have not seen a normal day in so long, and you're exhausted. You're not tired. You're fucking tired, and you're exhausted. You're dehydrated. You're drained because the energy is sucking you all the way dry. You have run into Incubus, Succubus. You've run into Mayor and Beelzebub himself. You've run into demons, and you have run into some things, and you just want to be normal. Because the life is not all that it has cracked up to be. It was not worth it. And you realize the pain that you have caused. You realize that you have led some people to the slaughter because of your music, and you have been honest about it. You realize now, because you've had probably some several dark nights of the soul, and you're in the Nine of Swords where you're all in your head, and you realize the calamities and the chaos that you have caused, and you just want to be normal. You don't want to go to the award shows. You don't feel like dealing with a stylist. You don't want to go to makeup. You don't want to do anything. You just want to sit the fuck down and be normal. Talk about it. Tell the real about the industry and how you're drained. That it's more than just what everybody sees, and that you're really tired. Because any event that you are headlining that leads in the chaos and calamity, it's only one or two things. It was orchestrated, or it was just by incident. Either way, that's a lot to have to deal with. And some of you want to walk away from the industry, and you're too far in. You're too far in. You know you want to just be free. Exhausted. It's real, y'all. How bad do you want to be famous? Moving forward. Some of you niggas in the industry got real street beef. And there are people that want to kill you. And you know that shit. You know that you have decided to mix your street beef with rap music. And now in your rap music, you are talking shit, telling on yourself, admitting to crimes, and all kind of just many shit. And now you and your crew came up with a dark idea, a not bright idea, that you feel like you niggas need to be seen on another level, and you feel like you need to book shows. Why? Listen, for what? You want to go and book this venue so you can let everybody hear y'all music. Nobody wants to hear that shit. Nobody. Y'all need to rent out one of y'all niggas' garages and just do your shit in the garage. Listen, every time you niggas book a venue and try to have a concert, your shit gets shot up every time. There has not been a time that your shit didn't go left, and you know it. You know it. So I'm asking, why are you continuing to book shows that lead to deadly consequences, to murder, to extreme violence, where there are innocent bystanders? Why? Why do you all keep making music that is talking about murder, that is talking about slaughter, that is talking about taking the village to depths of hell? Why do you only rap about violence?
Well, that's all I've ever known.
Know something else. That cannot be an excuse. That's why you continue to write and rap this type of stuff about this is all you've ever known. First of all, can you just write it in a book? Have you ever thought about writing a book? I'm serious. Have you ever thought about writing a book about the violence that you've experienced or seen? Have you ever thought about tapping into something else versus just putting music to this shit and forcing us to hear it? Yeah. This is for my niggas. No.
Anytime they say, yeah, 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 you know it's going to be some fuckery. Yeah, 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 this is for the niggas that think they get... No, no, wait, wait, wait. You know, and you always got one nigga on stage or two niggas on stage that's mean mugging the whole crowd, ready to just cause all kind of bullshit. I mean, seriously, have you ever looked back on your performances and just been like, yeah, this is some bullshit? Have you ever just really just looked back and just been like, we don't need to do this shit no more? What you mean, cuz? This shit. All of this. 50 of us on stage. This is some... You're the only nigga with the rap career, but 49 of your niggas is on stage with you. Make that make sense. And they're with the shit. Any nigga can get it. We always want to wet it. Wait. I'm in the front row. I thought this was a hip-hop musical. What is this? What is this? Why? Are you booking shows? Yeah, we got a show on the 22nd. For what? For what? Why? Yeah, yeah, come to my, yeah, y'all, and y'all, pull up. It's gonna be me. It's gonna be me, MC Taekwondo. It's gonna be Gutter Banks. It's going to be MC Sewer Rat. No. It's going to be Chopper 47. No, it's not. Yeah, streaming on all platforms. When is the bank going to dry up so your shit can't stream? Some shit should not stream. Some shit should never, ever fucking float or spawn. Get it out the water. No, get that fucking mixtape out the water. What you mean? It's streaming. It does not need to stream on any platform. Look, nigga, go get your mixtape out the stream. Now! This is some bullshit. Yeah, my shit's doing real good. You know, it's got about 24 Ks, and 23,000 of those Ks are you. You. Watching your own shit in disbelief because you can't believe you made it this far. Neither can we. At least we can touch and agree on that part. Moving forward. Y'all thought I was playing. I'm serious about this. I like music, real music. And I like to be able to go and come in peace. I like to, if I'm walking into something, I need to walk out. Walk it out. I don't need to be having to run. I don't need to have to duck, slide, nothing. Climb up a tree, hide behind anything. I should be able to be at peace when I walk outside. So I'm going to need you niggas with this low vibrating energy and these devil rituals and this demonic energy and all this bullshit that you niggas is on from the village. I'm telling you right now, you need to really, really, really check out of the music industry and stop with the fuckery. I'm going to tell you why on some real shit. All of you who choose to entertain Beelzebub through your music, all of you devil worshipers, I just want to let you have the opportunity to hear this warning, and it's going to be the last warning. All of you put together, all of you industry executives put together, all of the powers that do not really be, you don't have all power, and you're playing a dangerous and deadly game when it comes to music. Lives are lost. Suggestions and influences are actually entertained. And in the end, it's all going to go up in flame. Flames. You don't have all power. You don't super rule. You cannot make any final decisions. But you think that you can. You give off the illusion that you can. If it were pure, there wouldn't be any rituals. If it were pure, it wouldn't be any magic and voodoo and all that other stuff. If it were pure, you wouldn't be tapping into the dark side. You know? I'm concerned about you brothers that are being used like puppets. I'm concerned about you brothers who are nothing more than just a dummy to them. You are a dummy to the ventriloquist. I'm concerned about you brothers who don't realize that you come from the 12 tribes of Israel. That the Most High God is, and Yah, they're black. All shades of brown people, hear me what I'm saying. Okay? I'm concerned about you. I'm concerned about you. You tapped in too deep. I don't know if you can get out or not. That's between you and what you choose to cry out and do about it. I cannot tell you how to get out of you in that capacity. That's not my, I have to move out of the way. I don't have the answer for what you need to seek in that aspect. I know who you need to seek, the Most High God and Yah. I know that you need to repent, but I can't do anything else past that, but strongly urge you to stop fucking around with the dark side. Stop trying to be number one. Stop trying to be the hardest. Stop trying to be the gangsters. That's a new word. Stop trying to be so fucking invincible. Stop trying to be famous. Stop trying to dominate. Stop taking out brothers just so you can be number one and your music is still shitty. Some of you niggas be taking out the competition allegedly, and the competition's music sucks and so does yours. Who wins? Nobody. Some of you men are insecure. That's why you take out the other one. That's why you kill the competition, because you're insecure. There's no other justification for it. Too much talking in the streets, too much talking in the sheets. What the fuck do you expect? Chaos and calamity. Deadly concerts, deadly clubs, deadly. I'm serious. If you have to play with the dark side to get on, that should tell you something about what you're trying to do. How many of you niggas were called to be rappers? Be real. It's too many of you rapping. It's just too fucking many of you. It's too many of you. Too many. And you say the same shit. So, like, 99 of y'all gotta go. Because you're all saying the same stuff. Violence, violence, violence. Violence, violence, violence. Fornication, violence, drugs. Fornication, violence, drugs. Violence, violence, violence. Oh, we worship the dark side. That's all y'all say. Y'all say the same shit. What's new? What's new? Who's the hottest? Who's the hottest? All y'all think you're the hottest, and you're not. You're not. You're not even the hottest in your city. You're not even the hottest in your room. You know what I'm saying? Like, real shit. And you get envious of the other rappers, and that causes the chaos and calamities, which, you know, we can talk about on a micro level and a macro level. I'm serious about that. Some of y'all think you're the hottest, and you're not. You want to be. So that's why you go around writing what you write, rapping what you rap, and then you go out and you have your strap and then you do what you feel like you need to do. I mean, it's all stupid. Like, 99 of y'all gotta go. 99% of you all need to go. And stop with the fuckery and the foolery. Some of you don't think that there's another world coming. I think really some of y'all just, maybe you just don't believe. okay? Maybe you're just really, that's just what it is, and that's why you do what you do, and you're in danger. You're literally in the lava. It's deadly. It's dangerous. It's more than just the beat. It's more than just the bar. It's more than just the production. It's more than just the engineer. It's more than just the microphone. It's about what is really going on in this studio when I record. Who are you channeling when you record? What do you have to do to get yourself in a vibration to create the music that you create? Because the people who are listening to your music are not doing well. And you say that you're not a role model. If you're not a role model, then you have no business on the microphone. You cannot sit there and throw all of that evil out, and then when you see it backfire, try to say that's on them and not on you. Don't be no sucker now. Remember, you the hottest, you the hardest, you a gangster. You're a street nigga. So don't try to be no punk now. I'm talking to many people. I don't give a fuck if you don't like this or not. This is real conversation because you're playing with your life. You don't get any rest. You're haunted by demons. You're haunted by witches. And you have to keep this shit going. I know you're exhausted. You don't have to tell anybody that. You are exhausted and you look like a zombie in all of your photos. You don't even look like a human. You look like a shell of yourself. Now, to the average idolizing eye, they'll sit there and say, oh my gosh, you're my hero. But to those of us who are tapped in, we see deep, brother. You're in trouble. Sister, you're in trouble. And you don't want to come out anytime soon because you love the attention. You love the energy. But in order for the beast to be fed, you have to bring him his meal. So the question is, who's on the platter? And how do you get them on the platter? What is done to bring them to the beast so the beast can be fed? I guess some of you niggas had no problem sleeping with your leg hanging off the edge of the bed as a kid. You didn't give a fuck what was underneath the bed. Snatch you up. Hey, maybe some of y'all did get snatched up by whatever was underneath the bed. Me, the moment I would wake up and find my leg hanging off the bed, snatch central back into the middle of the bed. How long has my foot been dangling? Like, we don't play that shit with the darkness. Like, we, you know, as a child, you know, darkness, you don't fuck with. So anybody who does fuck with it is just like, what's wrong with them? Why are they going? They haven't turned on any lights. You know, some of you literally sleep in the cemetery. You don't care. Some of you perform in the cemetery. Some of you record in a casket. Some of you literally record from an urn. I will get into your business today. You already know that. Don't ask me to listen to your music. No. Buy my mixtape. What is it mixed with? Bullshit, fuckery, violence, evil. No, thank you. That's why they call it a mixtape, because it's mixed with bullshit. Chaos and calamity. Why are you in the music industry? These are the questions you need to ask yourself. This is the question that you need to ask yourself. Why am I going to this club tonight? Why am I going to this concert? Is it worth it? Are you going to enjoy the concert while keeping your head on the swivel? Will the crowd rush you at the tickets, at the ticket gate? Will you be crushed? Will you be in a stampede? Will you have to run and not know which way to run? Will you be split up if you came with a group? Will you be mangled, maimed? Will you end up in a casket? You need to ask these questions before you go and buy the next ticket, concert ticket, before you go to the next event. You need to really ask yourself, is it worth it? I enjoy staying at home. I enjoy my peace. I enjoy knowing that I am safe within the confinements of my wisdom, because I know that outside of these doors, anytime I walk outside of the door, I'm putting myself at risk. But why enter at my own risk voluntarily to entertain myself or to be up close and personal with an entertainer? With people that are on some or are doing some crazy shit. You don't know what people are on, what people have taken, what's going on, what they have tapped into that makes, you know, like you're putting yourself in danger when you mix your energy with that energy. You have to protect your energy at all costs. This world is real. Men are lovers of themselves. And anybody that is a lover of themselves, anybody who is a lover of themselves does not give a fuck about you. You better know it. Thank you all for being a wonderful listening audience. I thank you so much. The time has been well spent on the tour where we cover all aspects of the music industry. I am your host, Sister Speak. Tonight's episode, Deadly and Dangerous, When Chaos and Calamity Strikes, Concerts and Clubs. Everything that I played tonight was for the Fair Use Act, for educational purposes, and to raise and entertainment, to raise awareness about stampedes, crowds, and just overall demonic energy and activity that manifests in some clubs and chaos, excuse me, some clubs and concerts. You know, it's real. I appreciate you all for being a wonderful listening audience. I really love talking to you all. I love vibing with you all. I thank you all for tuning in. You know, my show is for those who like to hear bold conversations, okay? My show is for those who want to be warriors, are warriors. For those who used to be in darkness and now they are transforming out of that darkness into light, you know. Salute to all of you all. Shout out to all of you all who are making changes daily to vibrate higher, who recognize that you have had behaviors in the past or even in the present that just need to go. That you may have been doing some things that are dark, but now you choose the light because you know the light is marvelous. And you need to understand that about the light. It is indeed marvelous. Now, if you're looking for fame, I can't help you. But if you're looking for marvelous, I want to tell you that it is the light that you need to go towards, because darkness will take you straight to where darkness is going, where darkness resonates, and that is to Hades, that is to hell, to Sheol, to Gehenna, to the lake of fire. It is real. The devil does not give a damn about you, and I am opposite of that feeling. I care about you, and me having once vibrated low, me having been in some dark areas doing some dark things. I'm not talking about any type of witchcraft like magic or voodoo, but I definitely know what it is to be in the room with the devil. I know what it is for me to make decisions that were not for my greater good. I have made decisions that led me towards self-destruction. And then I had to go into self-reconstruction. Okay? So it's about saying, I want to do different. I don't want to be in a position where I am causing chaos and calamity, or I'm in the middle of chaos and calamity. I want you all to understand that it is bigger than just what you think. You're more than just someone being on this earth. There is a great purpose for you, but your purpose was not to entertain darkness. It was to be called out of darkness. So you don't have to vibrate low if you choose to say, I gotta go. I'm tired of the trenches. I'm tired of the gutter. I want to do something differently. I don't want to stutter. I don't want to stall. I don't want to be stagnant. I ain't trying to dip. I'm trying to do something different with my life. I ain't trying to live with this chip. You ain't trying to have this chip on your shoulder to where you got a grudge. Where it doesn't matter what wisdom says, you're not willing to budge. You want to stay right there and want to have this glare. You're hurt inside. So on this path, you're choosing to glide. But it's time for you to change. It's time for you to rise. It's time for you to get that red out of your eyes. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? It's going to be a time, and the time is drawing nigh, where you're not going to be able to make a decision. It's going to be what it is. Life is more than a face that is a thiz. I'm serious, y'all. I'm so serious. Seriously. I'm talking to somebody. And hopefully somebody. Thank you all for being a wonderful listening audience. The time, of course, has been well spent. And I'm going to leave you all with this.
No weapon formed against you shall prosper. This is Sister Speak with a word of encouragement. No matter what the enemy or enemies try to do to you, God will cause their plans to take no effect. And the pit that they dig for you, they shall fall in. If God be for you, who can be against you? Now say it with me. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. Be encouraged.
Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. The Lord is my rock, my fortress, and my deliverer, my God, my rock, in whom I take refuge, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. I return to sender all black magic, voodoo, spell work, evil eye, all mirror magic. I return it to sender. It has an adverse effect 100-fold in your bosom. I'm divinely protected, and so is my listening audience. What I just said is divinely protected. This episode is divinely protected. I only fear the one who predestined me, who has predestined me. I only fear Yah. I only fear Yah. He's the head of all principalities. I only fear Yah. We are divinely protected. Until I speak with you again, be encouraged.